It seems like the 49ers and George Kittle are far apart when it comes to the contract extension. And I think I know why. What's up, everyone? Coffee Break is back with another video here. And Michael Silver on Friday said on the NFL Network that Kittle and the 49ers are not close at all at striking a deal, which is not surprising. Kittle comes with a different value than most players because of his versatility at tight end. So it's not surprising that people are confused as to what his true value is. But let me explain it a bit further. Kittle is not just a tight end, and you are widely mistaken if you think he will settle with a tight end market deal, even if it makes him the highest paid tight end right now. You can argue that Kittle is the best 49ers player, ambassador, and leader on and off the field, leads by example. Of course, he won't say that, but I can say that for him. So now, how much money does he deserve? Well, I think you have to look at another position to truly know his worth. I'm talking defensive line. Yes. Pay him. Just look no further at Eric Armstead's new deal this offseason. Armstead received a 5-year, $85 million contract, $17 million per year, $40 million guaranteed. Kittle, I think, will land a similar deal. Pay him $17 million per year at the minimum. Where I think Kittle will get more is the guaranteed money. Why not give him $60 million guaranteed? If you truly think he's one of the best tight ends and think he can be a Hall of Fame player, I know I do, and so many other Niner fans and NFL fans in general, then he deserves that. He'll play out his contract and be ready for another one in his early 30s. Now, what I think Kittle's agent is shooting for, it's getting Amari Cooper money. He got a 5-year, $100 million contract this offseason, $60 million of that guaranteed. So you're looking at $20 million per year. I think Kittle is aiming to get that. Now, will he get that? I think that's a whole different story. But again, Kittle is not settling on being the highest paid tight end. He wants to get top of the market value as a wide receiver close to a defensive line. I think that's fair for what he's done and what he will continue to do for the football team. Kittle can block, Kittle can catch, Kittle can run, Kittle can entertain. There's nothing he can't do, and you can argue this upcoming year will be his biggest one yet. One thing that does not come up in that stat sheet, it's blocking, and he can do that better than any tight end. Hell, he can do that better than a lot of these tackles, to be honest. So his worth goes beyond just the numbers. The ideal tight end for a Shanahan system, and a huge reason why the 49ers were in the Super Bowl. We know Debo is the number one wide receiver, but the number one weapon is George Kittle. Do not get confused. George Kittle is the only jersey I owe right now because Kittle is my type of football player, someone who can do a little bit of everything, and he does it really well. You know, I haven't even touched on how entertaining he is, just removing the football elements alone. He can just be on TV talking about wrestling, and I'm glued to that TV. Kittle does a lot on the football field, but he also does so much to the 49ers brand. Everyone wants a Kittle jersey. Everyone wants to see him maul someone on the football field on Sundays, run people over, and just give us that first down signal. Kittle is football. Kittle gets recognition without being the quarterback, the people's tight end, and the inventor of Nationals Tight End Day. That is why he deserves this money, why I think the 49ers will eventually cave in to pay him. I want Kittle on my football team for the next 10 years if I can. He's cut from a different cloth, and players like this do not come often. Anyways, guys, let me hear from you. What do you think George Kittle should be paid? Go ahead and drop your comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, feel free to subscribe to get 49ers updates on a weekly basis. Thank you all for watching, and as always, we'll see you on the next one, guys. Peace.